So today we will start a new chapter, that is chapter 7 of NCERT 11th, and that is related to another physical parameters, the important parameters, work, power and energy. So in this particular unit, in this particular chapter, we will discuss about three physical parameters. First one will be the work, second is power, and third one will be energy, and the further classification will be there. So we will start from the concept of work. So work is a very common word. Work is done, work we are doing. So in physics point of view, the work is correlated with two physical parameters. One is force, means we have to apply force. And the second physical parameter, that is the displacement. So this work is correlated with these two main physical parameters. The first one is the force and second one is the displacement. If force is applied on a body, if this is a body and force is applied, this is force, it is applied. And if force ka jab notification ban kar, and if there is a, after applying force, if there is a displacement, if this is that displacement d after applying force, then the multiplication of this force, the multiplication of the force and the displacement is known as work. So when we apply force and if there is a displacement and the direction of force, one should say, like another definition of the force can be written like this: when a force is applied on a body and this displacement and displaced, and there is a displacement along the force. So in the direction of force, if there is a displacement, then this is known as work. So this phenomena is known as work when we apply force and there is a displacement in the direction of force. So mathematically, this is the multiplication of the force and the displacement. And one thing we should take care of is this force. This is a vector quantity. Force is a vector quantity. And second, this displacement, this is also a vector quantity. So these two are the vector quantity, force as well as displacement, both are vector quantities. So just by saying if the multiplication of force and the displacement, this is not good, because in case of vector quantities, we have two multiplications. One is the scalar or dot product, and second one is the vector or cross product. So here in the case of work, we take the scalar multiplication. So scalar multiplication of force and the displacement, this is known as work. So this work W, it is denoted by W, this is equal to force multiplied by displacement. In form of vector, this is written as vector F dot. If the displacement is represented by D, then this is F. Yeah, you can write S or displacement. So that the D is the displacement, or S, if you represent that displacement as S, then you can write this as S. So F dot S, this is known as work. And as far as the dot product of these two physical quantities is concerned, this can be written as mod of f mod of s multiplied by cos theta, where theta is angle between force and displacement f and s. What is force? Force is just the multiplication of work is the multiplication of force and displacement, and the displacement must be in the direction of force. In the original definition of work, this is the condition. And in form of vector, this is the dot product of force and displacement, which can further written as F is cos theta, where theta is the angle between force and displacement. Before going to the details of this work, we should also write its units and the dimension, because this is a new physical quantity. So the unit of force is unit of work is, so units, so that the absolute units are in MKS or SI system. MKS or SI system, what is the unit? This is represented by joule. And CGS unit, that is erg. In the second, if we think about the gravitational unit is concerned with the effect of gravitational force. We have the gravitational unit of force also. We just in the case of force, what we use in the case of force, that MKS unit is taken as Newton, and that it is dyne. This is that absolute unit of force. But when we talk about this gravitational unit, then we have kilogram weight and gram weight. When we take this, when we multiply that mass with acceleration due to gravity z, so this is that force F is equal to mz. In this case, we can define that we can take the unit as kilogram weight and that gram weight. So similarly, and the unit of this work is also force multiplied by displacement. So we will include the meter for the displacement. So the force is actually equal to that kz watt multiplied by meter, which is further converted into, just leave this term watt, and that kilogram meter, this is the SI unit, the gravitational SI unit of work. So somewhere, if it is written that kilogram meter, means this is the unit of work, remember this, or gram centimeter, this is also the unit, gravitational unit of work. Somewhere this can be written. So, and this is CGS system and this is MKS system. And what's about that dimension? You have calculated the dimension of work. So the dimension is just a force, the dimension of force multiplied by dimension of displacement. And dimension of force is mLt-2, mass multiplied by acceleration and multiplied by the displacement is L. So this is equal to mL²t-2. This is the dimension of work. And what is the relation between joule and erg? So you can convert this in MKS system to CGS system. This is joule and this is erg, and the relation is 1 joule, it is equal to 10^7 erg, and one newton in the case of force, this is 10^5 dyne we use in the case of force. So here this is the force and the displacement is in meter, so there will be 2 times enhancement. So 10 is equal to 10 power 7 and the is converted into 10, 10 power 5 is converted into 10 power 7. So this is 1 joule that is equal to 10 power 7 erg. So, and it is converted by using this dimension from formula, and we have discussed in the first or second lectures related to this. Now, what's about the direction of this work? Since this work is in form of vector, it is defined in form of the dot product of two vector quantities, force and displacement, and this is equal to F multiplied by mod of F multiplied by mod, this is since this is the dot product of two vector quantities, and the dot product of two vector quantities is actually a scalar quantity, that's why so work is scalar quantity. So this is a scalar quantity, so there is no specific direction, and we can classify. Now the classification of work, the types of work, it is classified into, can be classified into three parts: positive work, negative work. Work can be, whether this is a scalar quantity, but the work is a positive, work may be negative, as well as this is, there is a zero work. Push mat kar, that is zero work. Okay, now let us think about this positive work, negative work, and zero work. This positive and negative works mainly depends on, this is the third parameter, this cos theta. Force and displacement, magnitude ke form agar ko lete hain. So in the form of that magnitude, these two will be positive. So that the work is whether positive or negative, this only depends on the value of this cos theta. In the range of this cos theta, this is, if we have taken this as in between theta, if it is equivalent to in between 0 to 90 degree, greater than 0, as I should write. If this theta, this is greater than 0 and less than or equivalent to 90 degree, then this cos theta is equal to positive. Okay, and if this theta, this is greater than 90 degree and less than or equivalent to 180, in this range, then this cos theta, this is negative. So that positive work, so if we are applying, if this is that body and we are applying the force along this, and the displacement, this is the displacement S is along this. So if this forces along this direction, and displacement in along this direction, as well as up to 90 degree maximum here, up to here, then that work is known as positive work. So if the positive work is what? The positive work, if force and displacement angle between us, you can see, if angle between force and the displacement is in between 0 to 90 degree, then work is known as positive work. So the work is known as positive work when this theta, this is in between 0 to 90. So if this is that force and this is the displacement up to this. Second, if we are applying force and the displacement is along this, more than 90 degree. So negative work. If the angle between force and displacement is in between 90 and 180, then work is negative. So we have many examples of this positive works where we use the force and the displacement in the positive direction, in the same direction. If you are just pushing something and moving in the same direction, and just we can lifting that object. This is the examples of this positive work. And what's about this negative work? So the examples of this negative work is, this is the work done by frictional force. This is the good example of. So if this is that surface shock table and one body is somewhere here, if you are applying force along this direction, this is that applied force. Obviously applied force is along this direction, so the displacement will be also in the same direction. But the friction force, it is applied in between the surface in the opposite direction. So this is in force is in this direction, the displacement is in this direction. So there is just a opposite direction. That's why the force work done by this friction force on this body, this is negative. This is the negative work. Also, when we lift some object, we are doing positive work. But the work done by earth due to that gravitational force, there is one gravitational force, so that is also the negative example of negative work. This is that object, one force is applying along this left, and the displacement is also in the same direction, just lifting that object of mass m, and the force due to gravity, this is mz. So this work done by this gravitational force, this is negative, because the force is along the center of earth and the displacement in the opposite direction. So this is an example of a negative. So there are certain examples of a negative work. Now third type of work, that is zero work. So zero or nil work, there is no work. So from this relation, this W, this is equal to F multiplied by S cos theta. If the work is zero, work done is zero, only when, ab is formula mein dikh raha hai, it is clear from this formula, work may be zero first, if F is zero, if there is no force applied, आपने force apply ही नहीं किया, work is zero. So this W, that is equal to zero. So from this formula, if this force F is zero, work is zero. No force, no work. Second, if you are applying force, but there is no displacement, आपने force apply किया, लेकिन displacement नहीं हुआ, एक ऑब्जेक्ट को यहां से फोर्स अप्लाई करके उठाया और वापस रख दिया, डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज जीरो। इस ऑब्जेक्ट को आपने उठाया वहां पे रख दिया, डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज जीरो। एक ऑब्जेक्ट को आपने धक्का देकर वहां तक ले गया, वापस यहीं पे लाके खड़ा कर दिया। यू आर यूजिंग फोर्स बट सिंस द डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज जीरो देयर इज नो वर्क। आर यू आर अप्लाइंग द फोर्स बोर्ड पे, आपने इस पे आप फोर्स लगा रहे हो, इसका कुछ नहीं कर पा रहे हो, यू आर नॉट एबल टू डिस्प्लेस द वॉल, यू आर अप्लाइंग फोर्स। सो इफ देयर इज नो डिस्प्लेसमेंट, दिस एस इज इक्वल टू जीरो, द वर्क विल बी जीरो। फोर्स जीरो हो तब भी वर्क जीरो होगा, डिस्प्लेसमेंट जीरो हो तब भी वर्क जीरो होगा। वी हैव डिफरेंट एग्जांपल्स। एंड थर्ड वन इज इफ दिस कॉस थीटा दिस इज जीरो, कॉस थीटा जीरो कब होता है, दिस कॉस थीटा दिस इज जीरो मींस दैट इज थीटा इज इक्वल टू थीटा जीरो कब होता है
90 डिग्री।
तो इफ दिस थीटा इज 90 देन आल्सो दिस वर्क दिस इज इक्वल टू जीरो। जैसा फोर्स लग रहा है लेकिन 90 डिग्री में डिस्प्लेसमेंट हो रहा है, देन दिस वर्क डन इज जीरो। वी हैव सेवरल एग्जांपल ऑफ दिस आल्सो। लेट्स से इफ दिस इज पेंडुलम and here, so we are here, this is that pressure, it is oscillating like this. So the tension on the string is T along this direction, tension along this direction, and the displacement, this is the component of displacement, this is along this direction, just we take the component of displacement. Then the component of this displacement, this will be along this direction. So this angle is 90 degree and the work done by this tension T. Tension T on this bob, this body, this is zero. Why? Because displacement is in the angle of 90 degree. So these are the classification of work. One is the positive work, when the force and the displacement having angle in between 0 to 90, less than 90 degree. When that, if it is greater than 90 and less than 180, then this is negative work. And if exactly 90 degree, then this is the zero work. Exactly 90 degree, this is the zero work. And with this, if the force is zero, there is no force applied, the work will be zero. If that S, the displacement is zero, then the work product is zero. Okay, now some graphical representation. You can calculate graphically. So, graphical representation. Graphically, we have three parameters, work, force, and displacement. Then we have a plot between force and displacement. So this is force, but this is displacement. We have discussed several graph, and if we have this physical parameter force, it is work is equivalent to force multiplied by this. Force and multiplication. So we have to calculate the area in between the curves. We think about the work. So the work is equivalent to force multiplied by displacement. So in the graphical representation, we have to calculate the area in between the curves. If there is zero force, zero displacement, and we are applying force and the displacement is uniform in the same right, then we can calculate this area and get the total work done. Let's say this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is 5, and here this is 1, 2, 3, 4. So the work done will be, so the work done is, this is 0, A, B. So this W, that is equivalent to area of this triangle O, A, B. So this is half multiplied by basis OB multiplied by this AB. So this is equal to half multiplied by, what is this? This is 5. And what's about this? This is 4. So this is 4 multiplied, 5 multiplied by 4. And this is 10. So this is in Newton. The unit is Newton. And this is in meter. So this will be. So just by calculating the area, we can calculate the total work done. We have different shape and size of diagrams, and positive and negative works can be calculated on the basis of that also. If this diagram is like this, zero work, and suddenly this is another diagram. The work here, the positive side, this will be positive. This will be positive because this is in the positive side, and this work here, this will be negative because the direction of force is negative, so this is negative. So if you want to calculate this, this is 1, 2, 3, this is 3, this is 4 somewhere here, 4, and this is 4.5, and this is 5, and this is 6, and here this is 2. This is 3. Now you can calculate area of this 0, A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. So the work done will be W, that is equal to area of triangle O, A, B, plus area of this rectangle, that is BC, B, C, D, and E with this, plus area of again the triangle, this is E, F, and G. E, F, and G. You can calculate. So here this is 3 and this is 2. So that will be 3. So this is equal to 3. And here this will be with minus sign because the work is negative, that is in the opposite direction. So this will be 3 and this is 4.5. So 1.5, and this is, so let's say this is minus 2. Okay, so this minus 2 and this is how much? 1.5. So this will be 2 multiplied by 1.5. And plus, now this is how much? This is 4.5 and this is 6. Number? This is 4.5, this is 6, 1.5, and this is 3. So multiplied by 3 multiplied by 1.5. So you can calculate the total area, and you can get the total work done in Newton or given unit. Okay, and if this is not varying constantly, but the variation is like this. The variation is okay. If the variation is like this, then we use the method of integration. You take one strip of the displacement dx or ds. So the method of differentiation and integration is only applied when we take some very small range in the integrate or differentiate. So we take the strip of a very small displacement, that is dx, and the work is now defined as in terms of integration. So this is dw, that is a small work, this range, and this is force multiplied by that small displacement, and here I am taking dx or ds, so you can also write that ds. If you are familiar with this, then this is a ds. Okay, so f into ds, so that work, that is equivalent to integration of f multiplied by ds. And here the range will be given of the displacement, let's say it is from 0 to whatever that 5 or 7. So this will be from 0 to 7. force is given in terms of an expression. So let's say this force F is equal to मुझे इसको x ही लिखना चाहिए, ये सी पड़ेगा. So if this force F is equivalent to minus 1 upon x, or minus 1 upon x is square. This is given in terms of x. And you can calculate integration and you can get the total work, either in positive work or in negative work. So force will be given in terms of that expression. And you can integrate this and get that total work done. So this is that integration method, and also by using this method we are just trying to calculate the area in between. So this is for the varying force. So by using this varying force, constant, if there is constant force is there, we have very good blocks to find that area in between. But if the force is in varying mode, like this, somewhere it is positive, negative, or following a particular expression, then we use this integration term. So this is the method of integration. I think I should stop here. And the next day we will discuss about the work in some advanced level and perform some more calculation. And if also you should the practice of vector calculation, vector method. If the displacement is there, force is there in terms of Isaac, then you can calculate the work. So by using that vector dot product, this force is given in terms of vector, that is 3i plus 4j minus 2k, and this in the vector form Isaac long x, and that a displacement s, this is given as equivalent to I plus 2j minus 1k, just minus k. Then you can calculate that work that is going to F multiplied by S. This is just 3i plus 4j minus 2k, and this is I plus 2j minus k. And I think you are familiar with the dot product of two vectors. So I will be multiplied with I, and j will be multiplied by j, and k will be multiplied by k. Because we know that the case of dot product, I multiplied by j, and j multiplied by k, and k multiplied by I. Because of the angle between these two vectors, these are I, j, k. So what we take, this along x axis we take I, along y axis we take j, and along k axis we take along z axis we take k. So the angle is in between this 90 degree. So this I dot j, j dot k, and this is 0. That's why we just multiply I with I, j with j, and k with k. So what will be the answer? 3 multiplied by 1 is 3, 4 multiplied by 2 is 8, and minus 2 is multiplied by minus 1, this is 2 plus 2, so the answer will be 13 newton. So you can calculate, if the force is given, displacement is given, just multiply it, get the work. If it is given in form of vector, just to take the vector product, dot product of those two vectors, and you can get the result. If that force in the that displacement, that is in given in form of graph, so just to check which type of graph that is. If well known subject is there, just use geometry and calculate the area in between. Just use integration to find the curve if that force is in varying mode. Okay, so thank you.